Oh.
Oh, that's an easy one.
Huge classic.
Oh my gosh, this was that track back in the day. Ron Hardy played it, everybody played this track. If you didn't have this track in your arsenal, forget about it.
It sounded futuristic even.
So much going on, but yeah, just such depth and yeah, it's incredible.
When you hear it now, it's still like the groove, not even the sound, right? Because you hear the 303, the 808, whatever. But it's the groove that keeps you going.
Big brother Marshall Jefferson.
Yeah, super shout out to Marshall Jefferson.
There you go.
Well, the TV-303, I didn't really know how to program it. I just typed in some notes and that's what came out.
Sleepy D.
Lost control.
Yeah, we lost control. We lost our mind when we heard this track.
Yeah, classic.
It wasn't officially Acid House. I didn't name it Acid House because I didn't know it was Acid House and I didn't really know what I was doing. Acid Tracks, I knew what I was doing, so that was, which I also produced. That became the first Acid House record. So that was, Acid Tracks was released in 1987. I produced Acid Tracks too, but I produced this one, I've Lost Control, in 1984. It was released on Tracks Records in 1986.
Just like,
yeah, classic 707 business.
Yeah, even listening to the drums and everything, it just brings back memories.
Yeah, that takes me right back. Excellent.
Maybe one of the best 303 lines ever.
Generally, 808 is the drum machine most people used with Acid, but the 707, Mr. Fingers, and a few other people, it's just got more of a punch. And in some clubs, I should make a playlist of the 808s and the 707 ones, because in some clubs, the 808 is just too much bass, you know, so you can't really hear the Acid. All the bass is sucking out the Acid, but when you've got that punchy 707, ooh, that's a killer. It like punches in your brain, man.
This record had a great energy to it, right?
Tom solo.
Acid music was kind of raw-ish at that time in Chicago.
For us, that's minimal.
Yeah, I remember this track very vividly, yeah.
Land of Confusion? By Armando.
Labor from Bam Bam.
This is Armando Gallup. I think he was out of Jersey. It means may God rest him in peace.
Armando.
Land of Confusion.
Armando, Land of Confusion.
Oh yeah.
This was the first one I heard, I think, with sexy vocals. And we were like, oh wow, you can have crazy acid techno with really sexy vocals. It's just what a combination that is, but it did divide the room a bit. Some people are like, oh mate, this is a bit too sexy. But oh, the combination of acid and sexy vocals, I love it.
Yeah, man.
Who you think saying, chica? That's me saying.
Oh, I know it, but yeah.
Underground Records.
This is a commercial success. in the UK, but it was on an underground label. Go figure, right?
What is it?
Mike Dunn.
Big bro for real, Mike Dunn.
AKA MD3.
What a legend. Cool.
Yeah, Mike Dunn. But
track is called...
Tell me.
Face the Nation. Face the Nation.
Face the Nation.
MD3, Face the Nation.
Just absolute, one of my favorites.
Oh, I know this song.
Yeah, I mean, it's just so structured and it's, and so many levels on it, like so many different riffs. And
isn't that, this is definitely Adonis.
No, that's not Adonis.
Uh-oh. You can hear Adonis everywhere. Everywhere. I hear Adonis all through this. His fingers is all through this track. The drums, even the hi-hats.
No, I don't know this one.
Damn.
So good.
Is that Matt Warren?
It's Charles B, Lack of Love, but Adonis made the beats.
Really?
He's a genius, man. I don't know how many people understand what kind of musical genius Adonis is. The dude is just incredible.
Again, another sexy one. I mean, like, I always say sexy, I'm stupid. I've just been singing, really, but at the time we thought, wow, that's amazing. Acid and singing. Cool.
1988.
Charles B and Adonis, Lack of Love.
Desire Records.
Yeah, of course.
Come on, man. Yo, nice. Oh, yeah.
Shocking.
It just had this very sort of driving heavy that it almost goes kind of out of the house thing. And, you know, it's almost a precursor to the, you know, the early 90s acid techno.
Yeah, even better when they do this live.
Yeah. Oh, this is on Trax Records. I know that.
Oh, yeah.
Future.
Yeah. Absolute slammer.
Slam.
Slam,
that's it. I know this. Still nice though.
Evil acid.
Amazing.
The other type of acid as well, which we used to call never-ending acid, because, you know, the pattern isn't a 16-note pattern or whatever, so we used to love that shit, like, oh my god, what's happening?
Oh, I remember my mum didn't like this in the early 90s. She's like, what? Why are you listening to this? It's like, mum, it's really good.
That's so slow, though, for back then. Wow.
Yeah, it sounds, yeah.
120 at best.
What is that, like 115 or something?
Bam Bam.
Bam Bam.
Yeah, that's my favorite Bam Bam song. Where's your
child? Very sinister.
Where is your child?
Where's your child?
Do you know?
Yeah, they're at home.
Bam Bam, where's your child?
The Bam Bam studio, but Marshall Jefferson was living there. Mike Dunn was living there. K-Alexi was living there, and Terry Hunter, Tyree Cooper, Armando, and everybody else came through and just visited. Yeah, but when Bam Bam did this, he played this for everybody. He said, this is going to be the biggest acid track ever made. I'm like, all right. And it still holds up to this day.
You may claim to seek justice.
I know this track too.
This one goes down so well, and it's a little bit faster than most acid, so sometimes I forget. But if I do remember, it's right at the end of the set usually, because it's like 130 BPM. Oh, and then you're like, oh yeah, this track, oh my god. And everyone goes, oh god.
Oh, I know this one,
Still a good track though.
Reverb never been bettered, I think. Well,
of Swordfish Records.
Just sounds incredible.
With the smiley on the label, with the stars as eyes.
I don't know what that one is.
I see. Yeah, man. Jesus loves the acid.
I don't know. I'm doing pretty bad today.
Is it by Lords of Acid?
Ecstasy Club.
Yeah, there you go. I know, I remember.
Can you believe a weird story with this? Kind of a sad story. I was doing a gig in Birmingham, 1998 or something, and the guy who was collected me from the train station and drove me to the airport or the hotel or whatever was this guy who made this track. And he was just a bloody driver at that point. And I was like, oh my God, you're a legend. What the hell? And he was like, oh, you probably don't know this track I made, Jesus Loves the Acid. And I was just like, what, mate? That's one of the best tracks of all time. And the guy was driving cars in 1998. It's like Melly Mel, the rap legend who was selling comics by the late 80s from a comic stall. It's like, oh man, that's not fair. Yeah, this track's incredible.
I felt the heat of the beat. The bass took control of me and made me move my feet.
The magic charged through my body.
I needed some space. For this is more than just a dance. It's time to pump this place.
When you feel
I can hear the vocal already.
I still play this to this day.
It's not like a Chicago record.
And complain. So pump my body.
Pump my soul.
Pump my mind.
Take control.
Pump my body.
I can sing it all day with the I'm trying to think of the title.
Lazy pattern for back then.
No frequency, like no resonance. It's really, nasty.
I want to say that he's the lead.
No, that's definitely not him, but...
It could be piano vocals.
Oh, who is that?
Oh,
so maybe that was Felix then.
What is it, under Mario Diaz?
That's definitely Spanky.
Can you feel the bass? The Fantasy Club?
I don't know, is that Fantasy Club?
No, not the Fantasy Club.
Can you feel the bass?
That's Fortune. Can you feel the bass?
Fortune, can you feel the bass? Hot Mix 5.
Ooh. whatever it is, though, 151 for sure.
Thinking about this the other day, it's just how all the, it starts with all the riffs, beats, most of them very quiet, and then, you know, they come in, they have a sort of, they attack you for a little while, and then they fade away, and then another one, you know, these sort of phantasm sort of riffs coming out, and then you just got the, yeah, underpinning it, the evil sort of acid triplet thing.
You know, Ceephax would not be Ceephax without this track. I mean, I can't talk for him, obviously, but this track was the one where we were just like, oh my God, okay. And dear old John Peel used to play the English radio DJ.
Nah, you got me. I ain't gonna hold you on this one.
I should know this because this inspired Experience One.
Yeah, amazing. Incredible.
I know I don't know this one.
808 State?
Flow Coma.
Flow Coma by 808 State.
Flow Coma, 808 State.
To be fair, I think of, I know it's 808 State, but I kind of think of it as Gerald, guy called Gerald. I mean, it is obviously Gerald and Graham Massey, but the sounds I love must be Gerald, you know, because just by, like, the lore of whatever, you know, Gerald went on to do Amazing Acid and 808 State didn't, so therefore, in my mind, this is Gerald, the legend. I love this tempo. I wish there was more acid at this tempo. For me, it's almost like the default acid tempo, and I've made tons of stuff at this tempo, but most stuff's 120 plus, but this is really more like, oh wow, yeah man, deep and groovy.
Whoa, really slow.
Bad track.
Tricky.
When that riff comes in.
Okay, the bass line.
Solid bass on the DX100. Oh.
Shit, I should know this.
You got me.
Sounds like me, man.
Amazing. What a selection, man. Cool.
Yeah, nice.
I think it's Mike Dunn again.
Oh, fuck, I should know this. Is this Mike Dunn?
Is that Gene Hunt, Dry Yourself Nuts? Because that's what it sounds like, too.
Gene Hunt Living in the Land.
Oh, this is Gene Hunt Living in the Land.
Oh, that's funny. He'll be happy. I got you, Gene. I guessed it.
Woo!
He's been a DJ since he was 14. I don't mean a DJ like in his bedroom. No, the brother was out playing records at 14, sneaking out the house. Truly. When I say truly sneaking out the house, truly sneaking out the house.
There's three different artists on this one, but people argue about who it is, like Robert Owens, Gene Hunt, and the other bloody guy. Gene Hunt, Robert Owens, and... brain gone. But yeah, I put all three names down because they've all said they made the track. No one can seem to agree who actually made it, but it's usually Gene Hunt Living in the Land, most people say, but 111 BPM.